Okay, I'm Gary Witheford. I'm just going to go through the point work with you. The first bit of work will I do with horses when they first come to me. As you see, I've got a round pen here, and this is the most important thing for me, is the round pen, because that's where I start the work and understanding the horse's brain and understand what they do. So if I'm the red colour, the green is going to be the horse. So the horse will come in and he'll go round to my right. I don't do anything else. You'll instantly see the ear lock onto me. The ear, actually, it's like a little radar. The ear will tell you where his eyes are looking. He's got one eye looking at the pen, and one eye looking at me. He goes around three times, and then you'll see me run at him. And then he'll do one of two things. He'll either come at me this way, or he'll turn, which I expect him to do. He'll turn this way, and then you'll see me open the doorway, and then he'll do a flying change behind me. That's controlling the horse's movement. Once he starts to... You start to control the horse's movement, you start to control the horse's brain.
As you turn that fly around, at one, go the other way.
So it's important that he starts to look at you as a leader, as me as the leader, and then he wants to be pleasing the leader.
Now what I'll do, I'll attack him again, but I won't attack him hard. Watch what he does with the lip and chew and the mouth. High blowing, touching the ground, I attack. Now I don't attack so hard. Look at him now. Watch my mouth licking and chewing. And blowing, snorting. That's him talking and communicating. I'll do anything until he licks and chews. There you go. He's now communicating, now talking. There's the blowing. Now if I want him, there's a head down, now he's down the head, now he wants to come. And I come away from him. And all horses do this. Not just him, all horses. I've got to a point now where he wants to be with me. Now you can see how sensitive he is. But I can touch him. He can shake his body. And this is about the thing about the spurs and things like that, how sensitive. So I work on the desensitizing of the horse. And get that sensitivity working harder. So I just start scratching them. What they do then? They tell you what he likes. And they tell you if he didn't like it. So if I scratch his bum or something, no, I want it scratched there. And they'll do the bonding, do the. Oh. The halter work is something I do very quickly. When I'm introduced to a horse for the first time, the halter work is the most important work. And you'll see me work with an animal always walking behind me. Now, he taught me the fact is that horses don't like being led by the shoulder, but we're taught to lead by the shoulder. Now, I'll explain to you that the animal follows its mother, and we become the foal. Now, he's the foal now, so the reverse psychologist here, I'm going to be the horse and he's going to be the foal. So straight away, as soon as you start, he wants to go behind, he wants to follow me. But we then turn around and say, no, I want you to lead at the shoulder. But you watch a horse from walking like this to being very pacified and very quiet, so an animal's going to get aggressive again. As soon as I grab hold of him tight and ask him to come, look at his mouth change. He's saying, I don't want to do that. I want to walk behind you because you're my boss. Come on. He's hating every second of it. As soon as he doesn't want to get by my shoulder. But you've given himself then, loosen him off. Walk with him, he'll stop when you stop. If you step back, he'll step back. I met him, he was tied to the wall. He said he was unrideable, said he was a bad-tempered horse, and he was going to Holland that night for slaughter. See that scar on his nose? Now that was done with a metal crocodile teeth sort of thing. They couldn't catch this filly, and I said to him, look, if I can start that horse off in 20 minutes, half an hour, and get your son riding it, I'll take him home.